Could Scotland have another traitor on their hands? It looks that way. Welcome back, guys, to Fog Football. We all know Canada and Australia as footballing nations haven't really done anything in their history. However, lately they've been good at stealing Scotland players, taking players from Scotland. And it looks like that could be happening again, this time with Canada and a once upon a time wonder kid, Ryan Gauld, who looks like he could be set to switch allegiances to Canada from Scotland. And when asked on it, Ryan Gauld says, and I quote, "I don't see why not," end of quote. I'll tell you why not, because you're supposed to be fucking Scottish, mate. You're supposed to be wanting to play for the Scotland national team. And I think it's sad how players can literally just have that view on it. They're like, ah, well, I don't see why not. Honestly, I mean, come on, whatever happened to pride, whatever happened to wanting to play for your national team? I mean, you used to look at international football and it's like that used to be what the players cared about first and foremost. But now, international football just seems to be like a bonus for players. It's like, if I get picked, if I get to play some, you know, at some tournaments, then great. And if I don't, then who cares? But yeah, Stevie Clark isn't really picking Ryan Gauld in his plans. Ryan Gauld has never made a senior cap for Scotland. He's now had a senior appearance, and that makes him eligible to switch to Canada. What's your thoughts on that?
Oh, Canada. Right, I can back his frustration, right, about the fact he's never been picked. Because personally, I think he should have been picked by now, but that doesn't mean you job the country, right?
Should he, though? Should he be picked?
I think over the years, man, he should. What? I'd rather Ryan Gauld over fucking Kenny McLean every day of the week, man.
When's the last time you've seen Ryan Gauld play? The guy is playing mid-fucking-tier MLS. He went to Portugal, couldn't even get a game for whatever shitey team it packed.
What's Kenny McLean did?
Being a solid championship player.
Solid, champion. This guy's fucking went to Portugal. Mid-tier in Portugal?
No, a mid-tier in MLS. I never said mid-tier in Portugal. Mid-tier
fucking Slatan
MLS.
Was mid-tier in MLS.
What's your point?
Gerrard went to LA Galaxy.
He's an overrated bastard, man. Oh, release clause.
You're only saying that because he's going to job us out.
No, I'm not saying that. What's he done? The guy was talked up as a wonder kid. Oh, supposed to be the best prospect Dundee United ever had.
Andy Robertson.
And Stuart Armstrong went on to have a better career. Gary Mackay Stephen had a better career than Ryan Gauld.
I know. He got too big for his boots. And you know what? Fuck him, you're right.
No, what has he done?
Hee-haw.
He did not come back. He came back to loan for Hibs, like last season or the season before.
2 seasons ago, right.
And what did he do at Hibs?
Nothing.
If he was so good, would he not have come back? Would he not have been setting the Premier League alight? Would he not have been...
Right, my point was, I just feel like instead of giving these players who are pish, we should probably give this guy
a shot. No, I feel like he should have maybe had an opportunity throughout the years. But I'm talking about right now, 2023. I don't think Ryan Gauld deserves to be anywhere near the Scotland team.
No, I agree, but I'm just...
How can you... I mean, look at our midfield. You always talk about how it's probably our strongest area. I don't think Ryan Gauld gets picked. I don't see how you can pick Ryan Gauld for a Scotland team.
There's a lot of talk of Ryan Gauld making it to the Euros, though. Did he?
What, it's part of Canada? You don't think he'll be doing it as part of Scotland?
Well, it was the last Euros, actually, so... But yeah, I totally get your point. I back your point.
Like, I'm no doubt about it. You know, 7 years ago or whatever, 8, 9 years ago, when this guy was freshly coming out of the Dundee United baby changing rooms, I mean, he was hyped up a lot, and that's fair enough and all that stuff, but he hasn't really went on to produce it. We all know he went to Portugal. He had this crazy, like, 40-odd million release clause, and I think we just assumed that, wow.
You know what's mad, though? See, back then, that was massive. Maybe now you'd look at it and be like, that's pish. But see, back then, like 8 years ago, that's fucking insane.
I think if a Scottish player at his age still left the country and had that release clause, that would still be massive.
Oh, it could be massive, but I'm saying back then it was like, fuck, this guy has to be.
Yeah, that's why we all thought he was amazing. We all thought people saying he's the next Messi, Scottish Messi.
Be real, like Ferguson, I wouldn't be surprised if he had like a 40 million release clause at Bologna, but at the end of the day, he doesn't.
Would you pick Ryan Gauld in the Scotland team over Lewis Ferguson?
No, that's not what I said, though.
I know you didn't say that, but you're trying to make a case for him getting in. And I think his time's passed. I think if he was ever going to get in, he would have got a call-up seven years ago.
All I'm saying is, in my personal opinion, there's other people who should be out over him. I like giving people chances. Right, we see. Look at Porteous. Right, the guy couldn't. The guy could never really get a game. Right, he played against Ukraine. But see, as soon as he went to Watford, now he's gonna fucking start every game. You need to give people chances, right?
Well, to be fair, Clark did bring him in while he was at Hibs.
Well, that's what I just said. He played one game.
Yeah, but I think he would have played more.
Man, we saw the likes of fucking Andy Considine get a game, but Ryan Gauld can't get a game.
No, but I think if Portis stayed at Hibs, he'd still be getting picked for Scotland.
Yeah.
Right,
I'm just
okay.
saying, give people a go.
Well, I think Steve Clark does do that.
Oh, no, but I feel like...
There's previous managers that... Unless the only way you got picked for the national team if you played in Scotland was if you were for the old firm. I don't think Stevie Clark's like that.
No, Stevie Clark's a good guy. I love him. I love you, Stevie. Sure, a good name with me.
But yeah, there's too many players that get picked just because they play in England.
Absolutely.
Kenny McLean might be one of them.
He's top of that list, yeah.
But yeah, so we've seen Jason Cummins change allegiances, we've seen...
I mean, he's pish. He actually has no case to be anywhere near the team.
Yeah, in fact,
I don't know how Australia pick him.
Well, it shows you what state Australia are in if he can get into the team. Harry Souter. I think we could have definitely found room for Harry Souter in the team.
Tim Cahill to Jason Cummins, fuck me.
So yeah, Harry Souter could have maybe definitely played a part for Scotland. Martin Boyle, another player that I would have liked Scotland to have had.
Well, see, Harry Souter, right? He's as good as John, but without the injuries. So there you go. Harry and John.
And Martin Boyle, I mean, is he? I don't know if he's in the Scotland starting 11, but he'd be a good. Martin Boyle would be a good option to have available, in my opinion.
So what,
I don't know if Martin Boyle gets picked.
Is Boyle Scottish or is he actually Australian? What's the gimmick? Did he betray us?
I'm pretty sure he did.
Bastard.
Fuck, I mean, man. I'm pretty sure he's Scottish, but he's got like an Australian parent or something like that. And
that, I see that, man. That's no. I don't buy stuff like that. You play. See this whole. Oh, I've played in Saudi Arabia for 5 years, so that means I'm going to put a tea towel around my head and play for them.
I think it's genuinely different if you have two parents that are different nationalities, and you decide that you want to play for one over the other. I've no issue with that. But there's some players that literally have like they're on about like if Messi never played for Argentina, he could have played for the Spain team because he played in La Liga and lived in Spain for so long.
I know, it's stupid. What's he going to whip up the red flag?
I mean, wait, because he speaks Spanish?
I know.
Who cares? Who gives a shit? I know, it's like some of these, I don't know, like some of these rules I think are insane, but when Ryan Gauld was talking about it in an interview, speaking about Scotland and the potential of, switching, he said, I think that's a conversation to be had when the time comes, but I don't see why not if the opportunity did arise. Guys like David Witherspoon and Scott Arfield grasped that chance, and I'm sure they're delighted with the decision they made. I think it's still a couple of years away, though, so there's not too much point looking too far ahead just yet. End of quote. So, Scott Arfield? Didn't know he was...
Do you know he's Scottish?
No, I didn't actually know that, no.
He jobbed it as well.
Would Scott Arfield have played a role for Scotland?
I mean, I think it could have. I mean, obviously not now, like, but I think over the years, I don't see why not. When you look at people who were getting in.
Like Kenny McLean?
Yeah, Kenny McLean. Like James Morrison, people like that, man. Like Anya. I just feel like when you've got names like that, Chris Martin.
See, that's what I do agree with you, like, because surely Anya was getting picked in a period where Ryan Gauld was breaking through.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
So it's like, wait, I'm not saying Ryan Gauld, I think. You know, once upon a time, when the hype was behind him, I could have seen him getting the Scotland team. But, I mean, now, when he's approaching, he's nearly 28. The guy has literally done nothing since leaving Dundee United. He couldn't break into the Portuguese team that he went to. Now he's in the MLS, which is, I mean, let's be honest, we can say what you want about the MLS, but, I mean, it's a shite league. It's a shite league with players that either weren't good enough at the top level or they're past their prime. That is the MLS.
No, yeah, exactly.
Now, has MLS got some decent teams with decent players? Absolutely. But let's not pretend it's like a top league and players that are, you know, really good in their prime go to the MLS. They don't.
No, exactly. No, you're absolutely right.
So, yeah. That's it, guys. Catch you in the next one then. Looks like we could have another player choosing to play for the enemy. Not that Canada's the enemy, like, but, I mean, let's both. Anyone but Scotland's the enemy, so...
Exactly, guys. But until then, we're going to win the Euros anyway, so fuck Canada.
Tell you what, who's not going to win the Euros, Canada.
Oh, French-Canadians.
I guarantee we'll get further in the Euros than Canada do.
Hopefully.
Aye, till next time. Peace.